when you're out on the mountain on a like hike or something and you're gonna make a fire during the night, and if it's been like bad weather, a little bit rainy and stuff, you need to pick these on your way when you're walking and put it like inside your clothes so that it's dry when you're gonna make
the fire.
You just put everything in the middle, such a big pile as possible.
Take a pic of us.
I'm working on step number two. So, to make a fire, you need three things. It's heat, it's oxygen, and it's something to burn. Fluids or fuel. So, this first step here, like I said, we got some oils and there's a lot of air in here and it catches fire really quick. So as soon as that starts to burn, we have to like start building bigger. So the next step are these like small twigs or like, yeah, small strips of wood. Because they're like super light, super thin, and you try to get some air in there. That's why you make them pretty small. So one trick is to do this. To get a lot of air in between.
Oh.
And that will burn super good. So I make a big pile of this, which is the next step. Like as soon as that catches fire, we'll put on this. And after that, we need like smaller logs really. Like you usually take a log and make it into thinner ones. And that will catch fire after this does. So yeah, for these like smaller logs or whatever that I'm gonna put on after that one, I make these like air pockets just to get some extra air, and these will like catch fire so much easier
and lighter.
Yeah. Definitely not.
Because yeah, when they used that, they just took a little piece. Oh wait, hold on. So now you don't want to rush it. So like let that settle in for a while before you put this on. Otherwise, you're just gonna choke it. So let that really catch fire. Now we put on these on the side here. So usually now in the beginning of the fire, the flames aren't really like that warm. It's after a while when you get all the coal and like here. The best thing for your hands to get them warm is to put them like skin to skin under your armpits or like in between here. Get some like real blood into them, or like shake them off a little bit to get some warm blood into your hands. So if you want to just move around a little bit outside and shake it off or whatever, we're gonna stay here for like 20 more minutes or so. So what I've been showing you today, like the buildings and everything, this is how the Sami people lived for a long time. Now it's boiling. So what you want to do is to get it to boil so that it mixes with the coffee, and then you let it settle so the coffee sinks down. And the Sami people, they usually took this dried meat and put it in their coffee because it made the meat like soft and tasty. It's very good for the meat, but it doesn't really do much for the coffee. This is pretty strong coffee.
Yeah, does that have spices in it?
I wonder what the Samis thought of the Northern Lights.
Yeah, you haven't heard the story?
No, what is it?
So the Sami people believe that the Northern Lights, or these spirits, they could actually come closer to Earth and eventually kidnap you. That they could take you away from Earth. Like, to the dead, or whatever.
Yeah.